How have you found it this wee run of back-to-back wins, and how well has that been for you personally?
When you get brought in the team and we start winning, it's a big confidence boost, especially when we're keeping clean sheets now. No, it's a good few we've got now, and just try to build on that in the coming games.
For you personally, I know after the Old Firm game, you've been in and out, but what has it done for your game personally to have that wee run as well?
I think when you get a run of games, it gives you a lot of confidence to go and play well in the next one, especially when we're winning and the team's playing really well, like really good performances the past few games now. So personally, it's good to get a consistent run of games.
In terms of the man next to you, I mean, Christopher Ayer, I suppose there's many people better to play with. Just how is it to play with him? What is he like on the field? And is that someone you look up to as to who you want to be as good as?
Aye, Chris is a brilliant footballer, good defender. He's great on the ball. On the speed, when in behind me, he's got a lot of pace. So it helps you a lot. And he's a good, really good player, especially, I don't think people realise how young he is. A couple of years older than me. So he's doing really well.
It's weird to think that there is only a couple of years difference. Do you see him as a sort of mentor role, like on the training field? Is he one who helps, puts a word in and gives you, put the arm around the shoulder and helps you and whatnot?
Aye, definitely. He's very vocal on the pitch, on the training pitch as well. And off the pitch, just wee things. It's not a lot, but I think playing together, you don't need to say much to each other. I think we know each other's games a lot.
He'll be doing 60-yard sprints up the field and all that with the ball.
Aye, he does that a lot, but he's good at it. It's one of his strengths, driving forward with the ball. He's very good at it, and that's something that we look at.
Stephen, was there a bit of a frustration for you, I suppose, when you picked up that injury and you had to miss last weekend as well?
Aye, probably a wee bit fortunate, because I probably thought I was going to miss a bit more than just one game. So, came out with it. Not a lot of harm done. So I was just happy to be back in within a few days. That was good.
Yeah, of course, for you, as you're breaking into the team as well, you want to be there and available for every game.
Aye, definitely. We're short of numbers anyway in my position. So to make myself available that the other night was good, and to be put back in, gives me a lot of confidence as well.
You've obviously been in and around the squad during that disappointing spell as well. How much have things changed? Has there been a shift in kind of atmosphere and attitude, even at training?
Training is always, high tempo, good pace. Everyone's fighting for positions. Competition for places is massive here, especially the size of squad that we've got. There's a lot of quality in every position, so I think everyone's battling to try and play, and when you play, you need to go and take your chance.
Stephen, do you get the sense that the players are perhaps a bit more relaxed now than they were during the period when the results were going poorly?
I think when results are not going your way, you're not as relaxed as usual. We're digging out wins, especially the other night. We've done that, haven't really done that this season. The last 10 minutes, Aberdeen, really showed how their quality, in a way. The balls into the box last 15 minutes, and I thought we dealt with that really, really well.
Mm. And from your personal point of view, talking about your own development, this is, I guess, a really key season for you to kind of establish how you're going to progress as a defender. Do you feel that, have you realised that? And do you feel that this is a big opportunity at this moment in time as you come towards the end of the season in terms of where you're going to go as a player?
I think with my age now, I think you need to play a lot of games. 21, you need to start building consistently, playing games, and to do it at Celtic is the perfect scenario for me. To go and play a lot of games for Celtic is what I want to do.
Stephen, going back to
had you thought, Stephen, about
Celtic? I think you played in European games and against Rangers. Is that right? AC Milan.
Yeah.
Obviously, massive games. How much benefit was that to you in terms of you just recently getting back into the team?
I think the experience was huge, two massive games in the season, although we didn't come out on top in them. But for me personally, it was you know, for the manager to put the trust in me to go and play in the games of that caliber was was a big confidence boost for me.
Did that give you an indication of the level you're going to have to reach for a career at the top level?
Especially in the European games, you know, the quality they are coming up against is, you know, world class. You look at Ibrahimovic, you know, really, really good player. So playing in the games, it gives you a bit of reality check, you know, that's how good these players are at the European level.
What was it like playing against him?
He's a brilliant player. Doesn't move a lot, but, you know, the quality shines through in the end.
Thank you. Stephen, was there a point where, obviously, you're now a major breakthrough into the team and holding down a position? Was there a point when you thought you might have to move on?
No, not necessarily, because signed a 3-year contract back in the summer. Maybe last season, you know, I had to go out and get games. And, Martin took me in, gave me the experience of, you know, playing 15, 20 games in 6 months. And I came back here and, you know, that stood me in good stead, for coming back here and playing first team football.